Hey everybody, Carl here from Apt, and we wanted to make a quick video about some basic things to consider when you're purchasing a new television. These are just suggestions and obviously aren't going to be for everyone, but they're tips we've found to be helpful for first-time TV buyers or just someone who needs a little guidance without going into all the technical details. First off, you'll want to consider screen size. Make sure to take into account the space where the TV is going to be installed, especially if there's anything surrounding it that might get in the way. And don't forget, TV sizes are measured diagonally, so a 55-inch TV isn't 55 inches from side to side, it's 55 inches from corner to corner of the screen. And if you're debating between two screen sizes, it's generally best to go with the bigger one. It's going to be a little more of an investment, but most of the TV returns we get here at our store are because the customer gets the smaller TV home and realizes the bigger one would look better in the space. Plus, it may help curb the temptation to upgrade after only a couple years, which can save you in the long run. Next, you'll want to determine the type of TV you like the best. The big two are LCD or OLED. LCD TVs are otherwise known as LED TVs because of the backlight that they use. There's a ton to talk about when you're comparing these two, but to keep this video on the shorter side, I'm just going to touch on the broadest benefits. Now, the benefits of an LED TV are that they'll generally perform better in brightly lit rooms, where OLEDs perform their best in a darker environment. Plus, viewing angles on an OLED are wider, so anyone sitting off to the side will be able to see the picture better. LEDs, though, can generally be purchased for a much lower price, so you'll want to keep that in mind if you're trying to focus more on keeping costs down. For more detailed descriptions on each of those, make sure you check out our buying guide on apt.com. I'll have a link down in the description. Other factors to consider are 4K versus 1080p, and smart or non-smart. Because the cost of 4K TVs has dropped so dramatically, it's a good idea to go with 4K for anything 43 inches and above. Below 43 inches, you'd have a hard time telling the difference, so you can save a little by going with 1080p there. And for smart versus non-smart, there's generally not a big difference in cost for those anymore either, so going with the smart TV will give you the ability to access apps without needing a separate streaming media player. Plus, if you wind up not liking the smart features that come with the TV, you can always add a device like a Roku or Apple TV down the line to improve that smart experience. Lastly, you'll want to make sure it has enough inputs for all your devices. Since most of the newer products use HDMI for their connections, you'll want to focus on those. A good rule of thumb is to figure out how many you need and add one more. Things like cable boxes, video game systems, streaming media devices, and Blu-ray players are the typical things you'd be plugging in. These are all important things to take into account when you're looking at getting a new TV. But don't forget, if you still have more questions or need help with your selection, you can always call, email, or chat with one of our experts online at apt.com. As always, thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.